It's Kelly's Table in the Wilderness, and we're going to look at why socialism is satanic and sick. The Bible gives you the wisdom and the truth about every issue of life, every issue. In government, it will tell you what kind of government you need to have and what kind to watch out for. Socialism is being pushed by the Democrat Party, the educational elite, Hollywood, and the swamp rats in Washington, D.C. But socialism is a satanic, I'm talking not just a bad philosophy, it's satanic, and there's a reason for that. We'll try to get into that a little bit later. But let's look at it. If you go to John chapter 4, or John chapter 8 in verse number 44, the Bible tells you that Satan, he comes to steal and kill and destroy, okay? That's what he comes from, is kill, steal, and destroy. Socialism is satanic, and if you look at it, it will show you that it's satanic, because that's where all that comes from, is Satan. It'll show you that socialism is satanic in its origin and in its source. So let's look at it. Number one, kill. Socialism has killed more people on this planet than any other philosophy of government in the world, and your Democrat Party and your Democrat leaders are wanting to implement socialism in this nation. And let me just tell you something. There's bloodshed in the streets coming if they get their way and get much more power. It kills. Hitler was a socialist. Mark it down in your day book. Hitler was a socialist. It was the National Socialistic Party. And the people that are calling Trump a Nazi are the Nazis themselves. That's part of their tactic. They always accuse you of being and doing what they are doing themselves. So Hitler was a Nazi. 11 million people, plus those that his philosophy is called for in the World War II. The tens of millions of people that were killed because he started stinking World War II. Nazism is a socialist system, and it kills people. Then you got Stalin and communism. Socialism is supposedly the peaceful takeover of a government, while communism is the violent overthrow of a government. But they both have the same mechanisms and philosophies of governing. And so it kills. So you got Stalin. 65 to 100 million people is the estimate that was killed under Lenin and Stalin and their communist socialist regimes. So it's satanic in the fact, socialism in that it kills. Mao Zedong, China, 65 to 100 million there. And that's a wide estimate, I know, but it depends on who you're talking to, and it's hard to find out in those socialistic countries because they are not free, and they'll kill their people who try to tell the truth about anything. So socialism kills. It's the killingest system in the world. Let me say something further to you, that the 60-some million babies that's been killed in America in the last 60 years is because of socialism, because it's a taxpayer funded. Most of the women walking in at those abortion clinics are not paying for them themselves. The taxpayers are paying them through a socialistic system called Planned Parenthood, who's tacked up with the government to slaughter babies. Socialism kills. So if you want to know where socialism gets its roots at, its source, it's in Satan himself. He comes to kill. Secondly, he comes to destroy. Let me tell you what he's going to destroy. He's going to destroy, socialism destroys freedom, liberty, opportunity, prosperity, private ownership, joy, faith, everything. It's a destroyer. Every country that has embraced socialism is destroyed. It destroys, as I said, freedom, private ownership, houses, housing, businesses. They want to own everything. I know personally people in Romania and other parts of the Eastern Bloc country. I've been to Russia. I know what I'm talking about. And they came in and they stole those people's lands. A man who owns a camp out in Colorado right now came out of that Eastern Bloc. He told me himself, he's up around 80 years old right now. He said, Reggie, my family owned over 1,000 acres. And the communists come in and they took it from us and drove us off of us. And then they bring in their little bureaucrats to run their government institutions, you see. Let me just tell you something. Public schools have become now socialistic. Not only, they are a socialist, mini socialistic system. But the tragedy is they're teaching our children socialistic doctrines and indoctrinating them into socialism. And boy, you notice how they fight for the public school. It's a socialistic system. It's funded out of taxpayers and people who produce goods and services. But we're funding our own destruction. So it's a destroyer of freedom. It's a destroyer of liberty. It's a destroyer of faith. And I'm just telling you something, it destroys incentive to produce, it destroys creativity, it destroys prosperity, and it destroys every blessing that this country has ever known. You don't want socialism. I am so ashamed of the Democrat Party to try to inculcate socialism in this country. It's satanic. The devil's behind it all. And then thirdly, it destroys. I am telling you something, It destroys everything that's precious. It'll destroy, as I said, free enterprise. It'll destroy creativity. It'll destroy your incentive. It'll destroy private ownership. You'll live in a high rise that the government prescribes you. You won't live on your own place, your own house in town. Everything belongs to the government. Your business will be taken by the government. You remember Obama saying, you didn't build that? He doesn't believe in Americanism. He's a socialist communist. His dad wrote his graduating thesis on Marxism. And the Democrat Party is lock, stock, and barrel run by socialist communist people. And it is satanic in its origin. Let me just tell you how they do it. They steal by tax, excessive taxation. Did you hear what Biden said? Your taxes is going to go up if I become president. And they want to tax everybody to death and buy the votes and control the votes of people and keep them in poverty and in those cities. Let me tell you, socialism is sick. It's satanic. And you don't want it. And I'm going to say something to you. If you allow your children to be taught socialistic philosophies in schools, you ought to stop it. You ought to pull them out of those places, because that's what's going on across America. Where do you think all these Antifa BLM types come from? Where do you think they've been trained at and taught? It's in the government school system that's been taken over, just like the Democrat Party has been taken over and the media has been taken over by socialists. It's not the hardworking, everyday working people out here trying to raise their children and produce goods and services for the American people. It's the socialist philosophy that's destroying this country. It is satanic in its origin. It kills people, and it will kill. We'll have a slaughterhouse in this country if they get power. And secondly, it'll steal your faith. That's what they're trying to do right now through this COVID-19 deal. They'll steal your property, and they'll steal it through taxation or just outright grabbing it, and then they'll destroy everything precious to us, destroy our freedom, our First Amendment. They're trying to destroy our free speech now. They're trying to destroy freedom of religion now. They're trying to take our right to bear arms now. Socialism is satanic, and if you're a socialist, by the way, it's satanic also because Bernie Sanders is an atheist, and all of them are self-righteous. They think they're good internally. They don't see themselves as sinners that God said that needed to be saved and redeemed, and they don't see themselves needing to repent. They think they're the saviors of the world, and they're liars to the core, and they are murderers, they are thieves, and they're destructive. This Reg Kelly Table in the Wilderness, don't you ever forget this. Socialism is satanic in its origin. Until next time, stay right in there. Let's fight the good fight. Let's stand, and having done all, let's stand.